Welcome to Business Reporter's Future of Marketing campaign, hosted on The Telegraph Online. I'm Anna Delaney, and today I'm talking with Matt West from FIFO. Good afternoon, Matt.
Hi, Anna.
So there are hundreds of resources for brand and marketing managers to use to make informed decisions. Mm. Where are customer reviews on their list?
Well, definitely very high on the list. Customer reviews are essential to any business that wants to keep and values the relationship that it has with its customer base. If you think that around 75% of us as customers look at online reviews before making a purchase, it's pretty important that we understand, you know, what our customers are saying about us. If you think, you know, all the businesses that have their online websites, they're really just creating a window. It's the people that actually buy from you that turn you into a business. So why wouldn't you want to listen to those customers?
And how does FIFO ensure they work with reliable reviews only?
That is one of the things that, you know, we at FIFO have focused very strongly on. Both our technology and our service ensures that we collect reviews and feedback from people that have, the only people that have transacted with you. So you have to actually have engaged with that company, that brand or that service. So you can't just randomly go on and leave a review about a business or a product that you've never actually engaged with, because how would that be fair to the business or to any other customers looking at it? So, you know, that's a vital part of what we do to ensure that every business can listen to that feedback, potentially make changes to their business process, their products, their services, in order to keep that customer happy and keep them coming back, buying more, and hopefully engaging with them again.
You mentioned reliability, but reviews are very subjective by nature. They're about happiness, anger, juvenile ranting, satisfaction. How do you define reliability in this context?
I think really it's about getting to the truth about what someone's saying, why they're saying it, and how you can benefit from understanding what that is. I think if you're, you know, as a customer and as a business, you've got to be able to trust that you're buying something based on saying something that's true. Let's say, for example, you're booking your annual holiday. You've worked hard all year, you want a nice romantic getaway, you're looking on the holiday site, the travel agents. What you want to be able to do is read that with a sense of confidence that travel agent, that holiday company, I'm going to be booking with something that I want. I don't want, you know, kids clubs. I don't want building work going on outside. So if someone's left photos, videos, written reviews of what's going on, we need to be able to trust it, you know, as people to invest our money and buy into that as a concept. And I think that, you know, that's vitally important for any business to be able to do that. If you can't do that, if you can't trust that review, then how can, you know, a travel business convince me that it's a good idea to spend that money? If you think, you know, worrying about, you know, what someone said is true, you know, 75% of you know, consumers often worry about fake reviews. And, it, you know, it's huge news at the moment about fake news, fake reviews. Can you trust social media? So all of these things come together to ensure that customers, that consumers can actually trust what's being said and why it is I would give you my hard-earned cash.
And if we turn the process around and look at the reviews from the customer's viewpoint, do they expect feedback for their reviews? And how do you encourage them to participate?
I think, ultimately, I think it comes down to human nature. You know, we all like to talk, we all like to communicate, and we all like to be listened to. We have a voice, we like it to be shared. You know, we share it on Facebook, we share it on Twitter, on Instagram, all these various different means. So in the same way, that if we have a view or an opinion on something that we've bought, on something that we've invested in, be it big or small, we want that business to come back and acknowledge that we've said something about it. Over 60% of people acknowledge the fact that if the company that you bought from come back and say, thank you very much, or I acknowledge that you've either had a problem or you've enjoyed using us, they're much more likely to continue shopping with that brand or with that product. So now again, it's about trying to make sure that you can reach somebody very succinctly, very, you know, very simply. We've all been, you know, on sites whereby, no, just fill this form out, it'll only take you 2 minutes, and 20 minutes later we're still churning through questions and it really hasn't got a lot of relevance to what it is that I've engaged with or what it is that I've bought. So it's trying to keep that process simple, trying to engage that customer quickly, get an opinion across, understand it, and make them feel better about the experience they've had with you.
So let's say the reviewers form a robust focus group. The next obstacle is internal. Are we asking the right questions? How do you interpret that information?
Well, I think as much as anything else, it's becoming more and more important to understand what's actually being said. So not just how somebody might rate something overall, but getting really into the understanding, the sentiment of what's being said. If you take Harry from Hampshire. You know, married, his wife Julie, they're coming up for their fifth wedding anniversary, and he's ordered a great pair of designer shoes online. So the big day comes, they're delivered, he's not at home, so the delivery driver basically throws them over the fence, no one can sign for them, the whole thing's a bit of a disaster. So eventually they find the shoes, they come in, and Julie absolutely adores and loves the shoes. But from Harry's perspective, he's had a really bad experience. He couldn't find them, he didn't know they'd been delivered, and a delivery driver nearly got between his wife and a designer pair of shoes, which clearly was an emotional experience for him. So he potentially would have left a negative review about the company and about what they did. But from a company point of view, there was nothing wrong with the product because Julie loved the shoes. So what was the issue? The issue was the delivery driver. Now, you wouldn't understand that just from a rating. You'd have to get in and understand what someone was saying, the sentiment of what they were saying, and why they were saying it. So just using that example, you can see it's quite essential for a business to understand what someone's saying so that they can act accordingly, either change business process, in this case, maybe change their delivery company, and really then try and encourage Harry to come back and buy another pair of shoes next year for the next wedding anniversary.
So walk us through the process. What happens if we sign up with FIFO? How do you bring your solution?
It's a really simple process, and we've tried to reduce this to make it easy for someone to work with us. So, you know, let's say you're you know, marketing director in a fashion retailer. You decide, I now want to collect reviews. So you'd work with us, you have your new line of summer dresses coming out. You know, someone purchases that online. We have then the details of the person that's purchased because you know who that individual is. We send them a request for a review and very simply ask them a few questions. So they can be service-related questions. How was your online buying process, or how was your in-store buying process? Did the delivery turn up on time? And it can be product-related questions. So did the dress that you bought fit? Was it a good color, etc.? It's trying to keep it very, very simple to engage that customer. From that point, you know, we've collected all those reviews. You now then have those reviews appear on your FIFO page, so your own FIFO page, which lists all of that information. You can then also use that content, you know, on your own website to benefit from an SEO perspective, to producing new content. In effect, what you've got is great testimonials about actual customers that you can show on your website. So once you've got all that information, we then go one step further and we take all of the reviews, all of the feedback that you've got, you know, across your fashion brands. We crunch some of that data and we come back, as we mentioned earlier, about understanding the sentiment, understanding what people have said and done, which gives you that real genuine insight into things you might want to improve, be it delivery, be it sizing charts, whatever it might be. We can then pull that information from what your customers have said. So again, giving the opportunity to give a great experience to your customer, engaging with them, understanding what it is that they want from your business and encouraging them to buy again. Ultimately, we all want to come to work, make more money, keep some customers happy. And that ultimately is what we're here to support in providing our service.
And Matt, it's been really good talking with you. Thank you.
Pleasure. Thank you.